Right, welcome to this week's episode of Minis and Motorbikes. What are we up to today? I mean, I'll tell you what, though.
I know, we're slowly getting there. I didn't do quite as much as I wanted, but we're getting there. I mean, there's a lot to sort out still, organised stuff. I want to get the milling machine in. I've got a milling machine. I want to get a milling machine. So I'll get that in the corner. I've got a little lathe, but I might try and get hold of another one. So I'll do threads and stuff, threading and switching.
Good, isn't it? But it's getting run around in it.
Right, I'll grab the sandblaster in it permanently as well, but I want to convert it into a vapor blaster.
Again?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'll get it away from the car, actually.
And obviously set up the compressor better and all that. Well, it's a lot to do, but yeah. But we're slowly getting
there. You've got a new compressor, haven't you?
Yeah.
Well, new
Where my brother's left me.
Yeah.
When he passed, bless him.
All right. Anyway, well, we're digressing, as you say.
We are.
What are you going to do on the car tonight?
Well, I've got, because I thought I'd just send the head off with it all as it is sort of thing, but apparently we've got to strip it right down for Mr. Roper. So we're going to strip that down today and strip the valves out and all that sort of stuff.
All right then.
That's it really.
Well, I'm going to grab that because I don't want to get my hands dirty. I don't like getting my hands dirty.
Yeah, change there then, really.
Blimey, you got something there, haven't you?
Yes, we've got to take it all apart. Take the
valves out. Mind you, can you hear that noise? I think you got something up in your roof.
I think so, yes. Go on, you off. I think it's a bird.
Is it a bird?
I haven't had a bird in my roof for a long while.
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? Is it a... Yeah.
So yes, we've got to get those valves out. Now I think the exhaust valves are on this side. Uncle Peter will tell us probably.
Why have we got to get these valves out again?
So we can skim the head, because he can't skim the head with them in. It's down to us to take them out. So we can Yeah.
So what are you going to basically end up then? You just end up with the casing as such?
Yeah, exactly. And then basically he's then going to do reseat the valves for us and everything. But I've got some... Now, I don't know if anyone can tell us, but I was told that the exhaust valves on a R53 supercharged Mini are stronger than what they are on the R50. Now, I think Mr. Roper said that he's sure that they're all the same part number, and then when I've tried to buy new ones, they all seem to have the same part number. It says for an R50, R53, R56. So I'm not sure if they are stronger, or if it's just an urban myth, or they actually are. But I was going to buy some John Cooper Works ones.
Right.
I can get a set of them for like £65. So I was going to buy them and then get Neil to cut them in.
And you get 16 for £65?
Very good maths, Mark, yes.
Hey, I'm as sharp as a tack.
Yeah. Your wit weren't.
Yeah.
My granny would say, if wit was shit, you'd be constipated.
Well, that's nice, isn't it?
Right then, yes. So, again, I haven't got a clue what I'm supposed to do, how you're supposed to take it apart.
So, you haven't got, hence the book of lies then, is it?
Yeah.
Because you ain't got a clue.
Yeah, I haven't. I just haven't got a clue whether you've got to take the count, you know, undo sort of in the middle and work your way out.
You're just trying to build the suspense, aren't you, and enter an air of jeopardy.
No, it's proper jeopardy, because I don't know.
All right.
I haven't got a clue. I've never done it. I've never done one before. And then, hence, do these have to go on the site? Does it matter if they go on the site? Oh, I don't know.
Oh, well, they... So what, you're worried that, because they all look the same?
Yeah.
It don't matter?
Yeah. Is it worth me just doing...
But it might matter.
Is it worth me scratching on there, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8? Is it worth doing that?
Well, yeah, it might be.
Or just doing it in permanent marker, even? I don't know.
Well, it's up to you, isn't it?
I don't know. See, this is a problem, you see, I don't know.
Well, why don't you play safe?
Yeah. And what? Play safe?
Well, yeah, play safe and mark them. Put like, something on them, like, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, but see, if I'd got an engraver, I'd engrave on them, but I haven't got an engraver. So I'd engrave like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Mm. See, I don't know. What I might do is just scratch one, you know, just scratch on with it, because a rivet is sharp enough, isn't it? I've done it before with a rivet, was sharp enough to actually mark on it.
Right. What are you doing? What are you doing then?
No, it's not sharp enough.
It's not sharp enough.
So I don't know, I've got nothing to do it with.
You got any,
I wonder if I've got a scribe. I might have a scribe somewhere.
Oh, right.
Bear with me.
What you got there to scratch it with?
A scribe.
A scribe?
A scribe. Yes.
Is it a good one?
Yes.
Or is it like below standard?
It's below standard.
So it's a subscribe.
Yeah. And give us a like as well.
Yeah.
But I've scored that on there. I'm going to do in permanent marker 2. And I don't think it matters though, because I think, until we take them off, I think they sit on a bar and they sit in one place and they just pivot on that. So I don't think they move or come off or anything. So I'm just covering my arse really, but I don't think it really matters. I think it's just, I think they stay on there anyway. I think the most important part is when you take them off that you start in the middle and work your way out. It might not even matter. Open the book of lies to tell us.
Oh, right.
Feeling very Kevin Costner this evening.
I know, you've got your Who Killed JFK glasses on, haven't you? Yeah, look at that, look. That. Yeah. Did Kevin Costner have a double chin in JFK as
Why?
Well?
When he filmed JFK, he weren't bloody 57.
Weren't he?
No, he must have been about 40. And well, I was all, when I was 40. Well, I found the tightening sequence, so I presume it's just the you do the reverse.
Right. Okay, so now you've looked in the book, then you know what you're doing.
No one's none the wiser.
No one is none the wiser!
10 mil. Can't find me 10 mil. Both 10 mils have got there.
10 mils always go missing. They should buy you should be able to get a box of bits.
A box of bits?
All just 10 mil.
Is it 10 mil? Oh, it's going to be... Trouble is, it's going to...
Is it tight? Cool, blimey.
Yep.
That is tight, isn't it?
Yeah. Do I need a bit of cardboard and put them back in the... I don't know. Might get a bit of cardboard and put them all in there. I'll slack them all off first.
Slack them all off then. Slack them all off. I must admit, when I said, cool, it ain't half tight, I was expecting something a bit, you know, a comeback from you there.
What, not as tight as you?
That's what I was expecting.
Yeah. 87. If I had the right tools, really, wouldn't it? Unless Laser Tools want to give us some free tools, that'd be nice. Give us a whole set, toolbox of stuff.
Well, yes, yes. I mean, if all they're concerned about is the address to send them to, I'm sure we can rustle something up.
Russell's got nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
And get myself dirty there, look.
Oh, yeah, you don't want to get yourself dirty. You're really getting behind that, aren't you?
I am. Where are we now? 6-5. Right, I've prepared it earlier, and what I've done...
Very, very singleton of you.
I've done the... Actually,
completely blanked that.
That's awesome. So I've done the valves. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And then those nuts that are holding the camshaft thing on, I've done them A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So then I'll just obviously put that nut in. I don't think it really matters. So that first nut will go in there, then that one will go in there, that one, blah, blah, blah. You'll see when we get back.
All will be revealed.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just saying yeah and nodding along, mate.
I don't know what to have for dinner tonight. You've had yours, you see, haven't you?
I've had yours.
You have yours all cooked.
I've had yours, yeah.
Sitting, yeah. Okay. Now, do I have to make a hole of that something and then push it through, or?
I do.
Yeah. See, then you see, I've done it on a box like that then, you see, so then it sits through and they don't push up when you put them down.
I'll tell you what.
What, cold potatoes ain't hot?
Tell you what, you think of everything, don't you?
Not really.
Not really.
See, I've got absolutely no clue what I'm doing. Peter's probably thinking, oh, what's he doing now?
He's thinking.
He sees us at Brands Hatch or somewhere and he goes, You, come here a minute.
he's going to go, he's sitting there watching it now thinking,
crying.
All will be revealed in a minute.
Crying.
They're going to undo the thing and it'll come up as one, and that's all a complete utter waste.
He did say to us though, didn't he? He did actually say that I've forgotten about the drilling holes in the roof for the roll cage to pick the car up by, which is very nice of him.
Is that going to be easy?
Yeah.
Oh, is it?
I don't know. I've got to order them first. I forgot to order them, so there's something else I've got to order.
What, and that goes through the roof and connects up onto the roll cage?
Yeah.
Even though the roll cage isn't like strapped to the roof at all?
Yeah.
Because there's a bit of a gap, isn't there? It's only really bolted down to the bottom of the car, isn't it?
Yeah, which is a shame, really, as I've explained before.
Yeah. But that'd still work then, would it? Well, I suppose it does, because everybody else is doing it, yeah.
Just lifts up. Mm. Hopefully we'll never get to that. Well, it'd be nice to race a chuffing thing, wouldn't it? Well, then obviously...
What happened there?
I don't know. I don't know. I think I've done this totally wrong. I think I should. Yeah, I've just done it totally wrong. But we've got to keep going now, haven't we?
Got to keep going. Got to keep going. Live and learn.
Live and learn.
You don't know how to do these things until you do them.
No.
See, I've always said we're not like the. This is all about like the bloke in the garage, you know, in his garage or doing it in his home, trying to do it himself, isn't he? Don't know nothing. All he's got is a Haynes book and a few spanners and bits
and
bobs.
Book's
and
bloody rubbish. I think that thing comes off of there, like that. There you go. There you go. Look, so they do stay on there, so we just leave them on
there. There you go, and away she goes. That's one side.
That's one. Just do this other one.
And then, am I being silly, but I guess all these springs lift up.
Yeah, well, basically what you do is push the spring down, and it's got like a little collet thing in there. You have to use the spring extractor. Pushes the spring down a little.
The spring extractor? Da, da, da!
And then that comes out, and yeah, and then the valves, and then we put them in our little, yeah. It'll all be self-explanatory, I think. Mm. See, I don't know if Mr. Roper wants us to take the camshaft out, but it probably comes out when these bits here come out. No?
I must say, I'm not just blowing our own trumpets here.
What?
You know, I'm not just going...
Yeah, it's a lure pack, wasn't it?
You don't see this, do you, normally? You don't see this.
Oh, people f***ing up.
You don't see in the engine like this. You don't see stuff like this. You don't. I'm going to keep saying it. You don't see it, do you?
You don't really.
You don't really?
No. See a little bit and then...
Yeah. Yeah, there's probably a reason why you don't see it. I must admit though.
I must admit,
look. You got some well greased.
What?
I'll spray that again. You got some well greased nipples, Mr. Palmer. Oh, I don't know. Anything to fill the dead air, innit?
Yeah. A bit like your head, isn't it? That's got a lot of dead air.
Thank you very much.
None taken.
Love you too.
Love you. Oh, I'd like to thank Dylan Meacham as well for buying me milk today at work.
That's very presumptuous of you.
What?
As in, he actually even watches this load of...
He has been watching it. That's the thing, he hasn't. Right. Start off, he was like, oh. But now he's watching it, because he, you know...
I was at my local... supermarket. Yeah. I won't name them because we won't
call
my neighbour.
Supermarché?
Yeah, a supermarché.
Probably and Waitrose, knowing you.
No, it wasn't. And I noticed that Kandu Nagasaki...
Kandu Nagasaki!
...was up at the, self-service counter buying a whole load of paper plates and some shaving cream. And I can't put that two and two together myself. I can't understand why you want shaving cream and paper plates.
No. It's a bit tiswazzy that, isn't it?
We'll see. We'll see what happens there.
Oh look, just pushed that, but now all really got out.
You pushed it clean through, have you?
I don't know what I want to do with these really, because I don't really want to get them all caked with crap, do we?
Well, they come out well though, didn't they?
Yeah.
It's like boning a bit of fish, isn't it?
It is. Yeah, well that, see, they lift off and then the cam are coming out, you see.
What's to do that again? Do that again. right.
And the camera's set. But they're marked differently, aren't they?
It's just...
Oh, they're marked, look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They've got a mark on them, which you couldn't see before.
Right.
So that's good.
Where are they showing that?
1, 2, engraved, look. 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, but you've got to remember which way round, because you could start putting them back as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then that way, only 3 would be right.
No, it's from the chain end. From the chain end. It all works back that way.
See, look, I didn't
marked
know that.
It now. Look, see, look, if you look, instead what? Of looking in the thing, look, you'd have seen that I'd have marked on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, all right. Well, I didn't know that about what you were saying about the chain end. I didn't know nothing about that, did I?
Well, no, I didn't really.
Well, you just did.
I'm just presuming. This isn't clean enough, really.
Sorry?
This ain't clean enough, really.
What isn't?
What are we doing here?
It looks.
Right, so that's that light out then. We've just got to get the spell springs out then.
Yeah.
Haven't we?
Almost looks like, look, if you go down there like that, look. Yeah. Looks like the Titanic, doesn't it? You know. Right. Right, keep going. Keep going.
National. Right then, so we need to get the valve spring doodah.
Have you got a tool for that?
Well, I've got several tools. There's one here, look.
Ooh.
Right. I don't know how that clips on. I think that must clip onto the spring. So you put it into the spring and then push it down.
Right.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
It's the only way I can think it can work. That one, and then that pushes down and pushes that collet down. I don't know.
Right.
Someone lent me that, so I'm not sure if that's right. But then we've got this one, which is a more traditional thing.
Oh. Hello.
Which goes underneath, does the old doodah underneath, and then you pick the right one of these. Yeah.
I've got no idea what's going on now. Not that I had at the beginning, but
I need to set it up. So.
What? What, yeah. You want to set it up, do you?
Yeah.
You want me to come back in a minute?
Come back in a minute.
All right, hang on, I'll come back in a minute.
Right, we've got a compressor spring, get the collet out, and then we can slide the valve out, but this is a real cheap bloody thing, which I'm not very happy with myself for buying, but...
Right, so what does it do then?
Basically, it goes over the top, goes underneath onto the valve.
On the, yeah?
Yeah, and then you just keep dropping
it.
And
you
then
keep
just
dropping
keep
that,
tightening that on there, and then just compress the spring down, and then you pick the collet out. That holds the valve on that doodah.
Well, it works well though, doesn't it?
It's doing it.
Pushing the spring back, isn't it?
Spring back.
And that is so that it reveals that, what's it called?
A little collet. I think it's called a collet.
Ooh.
It's like a cone shape, look, as you see.
Well, let's have a look. Let's try. Yeah. Oh, wait, where are you going? Where are you going?
You see this it's sort of cone shaped.
Yeah, so it splits.
Yeah, and then it goes on either side of it, and that the cone, then
move
the spring.
Move your pinky out of the way, and I'll get it on the table.
And then it just pushes
go,
up
look.
And locks it in. You might be able to see it better when it's on the valve, look, on the valve shaft, look.
I can see now.
It's got like a, I don't know if you call it chamfer or what you call it. You might see it better there, look.
That way around.
See it better there? The shape of it?
Yeah, I'm with you.
And we just got to get the rest of that out.
Have you got the other side off as well?
No, I've just got to...
There you go, look.
Things picks out.
See, again, I'm saying it again, we're right in here, look. We're right in. You don't see this normally.
Should be doing it in a magnet, really.
You don't see this normally.
Slacking it back off.
Slacking it back off.
Bloody thing.
That bar falls out all the time, doesn't it?
It's doing
that's a bit. That's a bit of a challenge, that bar, isn't it? Never mind, eh?
Is it called Mark Jackson?
There's no need to be like that. Look at this, look. So then...
See, really, what I need is a more expensive one, because we can't get this one to work. It's got the same sort of system as that, so you literally just pull the handle down, it pushes it in and it pulls it out.
Yeah.
It's a bit long-winded, but... Yeah, this is only 20 quid compared to 80 quid, so...
Well, it's doing the job, though, isn't it?
It's doing it.
Ping! Something went pop, knit your own trousers.
Yeah, so that's that. So I'll get that valve out, look.
Right, and then the valve just comes out the other side, look.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
there you go.
Right, then the new ones here, it'll reseat that, put a new seat on it and reseat them. And...
Right.
Yeah.
And that's all that holds that together then? Yeah. It's just literally pushed in that.
Yeah.
That just pushes in there.
Yeah.
Comes out the other side.
Yeah.
And then the spring, and then the other bits go around, and it opens up and shuts. And
yeah.
I'm going to try and be knowledgeable here, because which one then opens up to let the fumes out?
This side or this side?
Right. And then the other one opens up to
let air in.
Let air in.
Suck, squeeze, bang, blow.
What?
Suck, squeeze, bang, blow. Bit like a Newport disco back in the 80s.
Right, so it's just a matter then of going all the way down all of them.
Yeah.
Rinse and repeating.
Who's Vince?
Vince and repeat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah.
Said basically again. I haven't said that for years.
All right, well, we'll let you crack on with it then.
Yeah.
Should we put a bit of music over it while you crack on?
Yeah.
All right.
And go backwards.
Look at that, look.
So we go back that way now.
You flipped that over, well, didn't you?
I did.
I think you flipped things over before, weren't you?
Are we talking cars or women? Were you being facetious and saying cars?
There's no need to start getting rude.
Were you being facetious and meaning cars, were you?
That's the last one then.
Last one. Number 16.
Last one. Yeah. That all went quite well in the end, didn't it?
Did actually. Yeah, don't buy a cheap bloody valve.
Well, we've got a top tip though, haven't we?
Yeah.
We've got a top tip. That bar.
Yeah, tape it.
That bar that goes in there, tape it on.
Tape it on.
Because otherwise it just keeps falling out the floor. You spend more time picking it up off the floor.
It's getting so annoying.
You're like, well, yes. I can't
buy a cheap dude. I keep swearing tonight. Boss, spend 80 quid on a decent doodle.
Done the job though.
You've done it, but yeah. I don't know whether these just.
What the spark plug do?
Why put the last dude on? Yeah, so what, I'm going to replace those as well.
Oh, hang on a minute, what are you doing?
Those valve guides, I'm going to replace them as well, put new ones in.
Right.
So they've got to come out at some point, but we'll ask them whether they come out first or what. He might even put some in for us.
Right. But that...
That's it.
That's now at the state then.
Yeah.
Where...
And it gets sent off.
And that's the bit that...
Yeah.
That's the bit that he skims off, is it?
Yeah.
And he skims it off just fractions.
Yeah, not even a millimetre. Not even a thous└============
Skid it flat, really, and increases the compression
of the engine, so it makes it a little bit quicker.
Right.
Then we retard the engine as well. Yeah, so then that increases, I think that helps sort of like with third gear coming out the corners and stuff. Yeah. Sure.
And it's all kind of like acceptable to skim the...
Yeah.
I mean, I know obviously you've got to skim the engine to make sure you get all the gaskets to seal and everything and all that. But we are skimming it to get a little bit more compression, and that's all.
Yeah.
That's all.
Yeah, there's a certain amount you can only go to, you can't go any more. But then again, it can have an adverse effect if you take too much off, so it's all a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, excuse me for burping.
Right, well, no, what were you swearing and you're burping? And
I know, I've been really swearing tonight. I'm ever so sorry, there's going to be a lot of. tonight. Oh, yes.
Yeah, there's some other things you wanted me to talk about, aren't there?
Found the old doodahs. I still don't know whether they have to go on or not, the old mudguards. So perhaps Uncle Peter can tell us.
Okay. What, because if they don't go on, that's extra weight, isn't it?
Well, no, it's not the weight, it's just, I think it's going to stop all the mud and water coming up and all that sort of
all
stuff.
All right.
And also, look, I found these that I bought ages ago for the classic Mini, look. Look.
What's that?
Steering column surround, look.
Oh,
put
yes.
Put a key in the indicator, look.
Yeah, I'm with you now.
I must have bought this, five years ago.
Right.
And a pucker steering wheel, look.
Oh, look at that, look. Hey?
Look at that. Hey?
Crikey. Looks all right, doesn't it?
So that'll be all right, won't it?
Yeah. And that's for the other Mini that we're going to do.
Yeah, the classic Mini.
Right.
And the NGZR that was in here, I'll strip the brake pedals out and the servo and everything and the steering column and the centre console that run down the middle. I've stripped all that out. I thought we could use that in some of the builds, perhaps later on, one of the builds.
Right.
I'm wondering if that's a good idea to use them in the classic Mini, in the other things we're going to do, because obviously we're going to do more classic Minis. I'd like to do a 4x4 classic Mini using... perhaps the engine and running gear out of a Fiat, is it a Fiat Uno? 4x4, was it in the Uno they did the 4x4? Or the Panda, might be Ford the Fiat Panda. Feel quite
different. Uno, like it couldn't have been the Uno.
No. Uno, not Uno, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. And,
yes.
If I turn right round now,
yes.
Like that, look. There is the car. Fine.
Oh yes, something else as well.
Yeah.
Did I mention it earlier?
No, it's hanging on a wall after you painted it, look.
When I bought the engine for it, the Rotax engine for it, the chap who I bought the engine off gave me a list of stuff I needed. I wrote it down on a bit of Amazon thingy because that's all I have. And I thought I'd lost it. And it tells you what, 50 to 60 degrees, 83 sprocket and all that. It's written it all down, look. Clutch drum, 12 teeth, look, spark plug in the 29 hour, look. So I found it, so I'm well happy because I thought I'd lost that. A lot of information.
And that's
there.
For the engine that's going in the car?
Yeah, yeah.
Which is I mean, the blue paint come up alright,
yeah.
Didn't it? Looks
some
quite
of it
nice.
Did, yeah.
Some of it did.
Yeah.
That looks alright, that.
Yeah, it'd be alright, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
It's only for mucking about and getting a bit of track time, isn't it?
Yeah.
Bit of racecraft. Bit of racecraft.
There you are. I nearly lost you then for a minute, look.
How could you?
Well, there you go.
So is that about it then, really?
Well, I've had tonight.
I'm tired tonight, yeah.
You do? You look tired. You look tired. Yeah.
Yeah, look, my whole face is drooping, like you said.
Yeah.
Earlier, thanks very much. Because I'm very, very happy.
Fine, well, that all worked out all right, didn't it?
I think so.
I think you got all that undone in the... I mean, I know it was all a little bit to start with, but that
I'm
all
still
went
not
all
sure
right, didn't it?
If someone could tell what I should have done, because I know I haven't really done it right, and that valve spring compressor thing was just...
Did the job, though, didn't it?
Well, it's...
Did the job? I don't know. Never happy, are you? Never happy. I tell you what, we've finished the episode now,
yeah.
So you can do the bit you like doing, you know, with the old...
Thank you very, very much, everybody. Don't forget to like and subscribe and give us a lovely thumbs up and a lovely comment. It'd be so, so much appreciated. Thank you so, so much.
Did that well, didn't you? I think you did that better than that. Yeah, I know a bit of a trick with one of these. If you get like a bit of metal that's got a bit stuck or a bit wedged in, you warm it up with this.
Like tighten up or something.
Yeah, you warm it up with this, don't you? And it releases the molecules, doesn't it? And it makes it come off easy, doesn't it?
Releases.
All you got to do is press this button to fire it up. Look, watch, I'll show you.
Oh, 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 oh,